In late February came an announcement. Astronomers had discovered TRAPPIST-1, a potentially habitable planetary system. The planets were Earth-sized and rocky. There were 7, that's so many planets probably. Now that the media has stopped losing their collective chill, Seeker is here to bring y'all back down. This is the image you probably saw of TRAPPIST-1. Beautiful, right? Well, guess what, sport? That's an artist rendition. Here is the actual image that we see of TRAPPIST-1. That's the star. The planets are too small to be seen. I mean, it's still great though, revel, love. Okay, now, you cannot move to TRAPPIST-1, you cannot live on TRAPPIST-1, chances are nothing else lives there either. That said, it's still really exciting. To catch you up, the hubbub came when NASA announced a multi-planet system 39 light years from Earth. The scientific paper it was published in Nature, that detailed everything. The 7 exoplanets are Earth-sized, not the same as Earth-like. They orbit really close to their star TRAPPIST-1, and the star is less than a tenth of the size of our sun, and colder. Also dark. So several of the Earth-sized planets are in what's called the habitable zone, meaning they orbit the perfect distance to get surface temperatures that could support liquid water, though that doesn't necessarily mean they have any. Some scientists got carried away calling TRAPPIST-1 our sister solar system, and some of your Twitter friends were totally ready to move there. Again, all very exciting. Then, to add to the hype, another study of the TRAPPIST-1's planets found that they are so close together that if they were to harbor life, and nobody said that they would, any meteor impact on one could throw life onto their neighbors, like blood spatter. It's called panspermia. I should mention, they hedged their bets on this, writing that the vacuum of space would make it really hard for life to move from one planet to another, but if there was life on one, then there probably would be life on more than one. But now, as is scientists' job, a group pointed the Hubble at TRAPPIST and were like, whoa, 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 slow your yaw, NASA. With all these planets being so close to their cool dwarf star, the farthest is 94% closer than Earth, they are definitely bathed in radiation. X-rays mostly. TRAPPIST could release enough X-ray energy to strip all of its planets of their atmospheres. Yeah, chances are these Earth-sized rocks don't have an atmosphere there to support life or your Twitter friends. On top of that, when planets are as close to their star as the TRAPPIST-1 planets are, gravity makes them tidally locked, meaning they don't spin relative to their orbit. The light side bakes while the dark side is super cold, further decreasing the chances for life. There is a small glimmer of hope. If perchance the system is only 500 million years old, then the planets might still have their atmospheres. The X-rays wouldn't have had time to blow them away. The Hubble data also could show there might be water vapor in the upper atmosphere of the planets, but there are no guarantees. More research is needed. So again, probably no atmospheres, probably no spinning, probably no life, but still really exciting. This is the most number of planets around a single star, and the most that could hold liquid water. Reminder, we didn't know there were any planets outside of our solar system until 1992. And if any of those planets have volcanic activity or a magnetic field to protect their surface like we do, then they might have some type of life on them. We're gonna have to keep an eye on this system and we'll update you if they find anything else out, because trust me, they'll be looking. In light of all this, would you still want to visit TRAPPIST-1? Tell us your thoughts in the comments. What if Pluto was a planet again? What if our moon was a planet? What if we had 110 planets in our solar system? All of these things could happen. To learn more, watch this video. Thanks for watching, everybody. See you next time.